has ever experienced in its entire life.
You don't think the people going to all the town halls and saying no and the poll numbers plunging will make the establishment back off? I think if the establishment thought Obama was still going to be messianic, they were building him up for this. I just see them, they always try over and over again, and this is their biggest try so far. I just don't see it going well for them if they do engage.
Well, and let me say this. I'm not telling anybody not to do those things. I'm also of the opinion that immediately those of men, the men of, and women of means and who have the ability, we should be having recall petitions going out. But here's the deal. The question then is, becomes on the other side of it. Does that even threaten them more to move up their time frame? I think, Alex, that the bottom line is the advantage of informing people is if we get that extra law enforcement officer, if we get that extra DEA agent, if we get the extra Border Patrol guy, if we save their families' lives and they finally come to grips with the fact that, hey, if we're ordered to any part of the United States to be away from our family, who's going to take care of them? And then they're being told, don't expect any resupply. I said, listen, ladies and gentlemen, you who take part in the deployment throughout the country in law enforcement to other states have just signed your death warrants and the death warrants.
And by the way, in 1988, they tried to make a federal law where all cable systems and phones, where the feds would dial in and give you messages. We just put up an Idaho news article, kpak.com, Idaho officials working on statewide alert system where Homeland Security takes over the radio, the phone, everything. I told people this in Police State 2000 in 1999 because I work in radio and FEMA came in and took over and put in their control box where everything goes through them. It is all really coming together right now, Steve. And I just, it's like we're going to have our own Mao Zedong here in America. And I just wish to God this wasn't the case. And I hope we can stop it. Let's take some phone calls. Common side effects, calling from Hawaii. Never had a caller with a name like that. Go ahead, caller.
Hey, good morning, Alex. Hey, good morning, Steve.
Good morning.
Yeah, remind people to remind the listeners of May 13th, 1985, the city of Philadelphia dropped a bomb on the MOVE organization and burned down a whole city block. Now, a lot of people have been knowing that the government and the system is capable of these things. Have been targeted in the past, and you know, it's been, you know, people haven't come out and really supported these other humans like they really should have in this time of genocide. Now, as far as Alex, my personal opinion, I don't think you're racist. I'm a person of color, and I don't think it really matters if you're racist or not, in all honesty. I mean, your information is crucial, and certain information that you share with the audience, it doesn't have anything to do with racism. It has something
But a racist wouldn't make a film like Endgame about how they're targeting black and Hispanic babies for abortion and infanticide and injecting black people with syphilis. It's the people that talk about race all day. They want to get everybody fighting with each other so they can, Margaret Sanger and Rockefellers brag how they come up and pose through the community groups to kill you.
Right, and you have been coming out with the crucial information. Now, not to say that people of color could still, you know, be critical and, you know, because, for instance, the King Alfred plan and the update of that, the Rex 84 plan, that needs to be read on the air to your million of listeners. This is an 8-hour plan of how they're going to localize all the enforcement and then come in and divide up the families, put people in concentration camps, and then their end game is the mass burn trash incineraries that get up to 5,000 degrees. That is what they're trying to, this is their final solution, because in Nazi Germany, they were killing 10,000 people a day, and the ash from burning up folks caused a bottleneck. So it slowed down the production, per se. And so,
well, God bless you. Common side effects. We got to go to break, but God bless you and your points. We're going to come back and take more calls. Quick comment, Steve Quayle, on what he was saying.
Well, first of all, I agree with what he was saying about the end game, and that is to basically kill the people and incinerate them and get them out of every form of eyesight possible. But I think that more importantly, Alex, is that They have an end game. And remember, this is the globalists. This isn't just the willing dupes in the U.S. military, the U.S. Law and justice.
Stay there. Explain when we get back. Steve Quayle. This is Alex.